Sarah from Mary's Milk Monsters, and today I'm going to show you how to make butter with this food processor so that it can be done really quickly. Now, since I'm using goat milk cream, it had to be run through a cream separator because goat milk does not separate like cow milk. And then after we ran the cream, we put it in the fridge just to chill for a bit. And then we're going to put it in here and make butter. And we're gonna put about a pint of it, which is about the top, about there, or around 500 milliliters. There. So we're gonna scoop it out of the way. Right, so I have my food processor here, which has a lid attachment. And then we're going to pour it in here. And this usually takes around 5 minutes-ish, somewhere in that range, to turn it into the butter. So what we're looking for is it's going to spin like this for a while, and then it will slow down, and then once it slows down it will be whipped cream, which I'll show you when it hits that stage. And then after it turns into whipped cream, it's going to turn a little bit more, and then the buttermilk and the butter will separate and splash all around. And then we will put it in here, get all the butter, as much buttermilk as we can out of it so that it doesn't spoil in the fridge or freezer. We put it in the freezer to help it last longer. And then I'm gonna salt it because I like salted butter. You could add other things to the butter to flavor it, like I know some people put herbs, some people put cheese culture in the cream, so that it's cultured butter. I know some people put like honey or maple syrup. Because I like to just have it as salted so that it can go in more recipes like butter cookies or cake. Or what else could I do with butter? I just put it on toast. Yeah, I do a lot of stuff with butter. What am I gonna do with this brown butter? Probably just eat it. Alright, so starting to slow down a little bit. Just thinking. Let's see. What else would I do with this butter? Cookies, cake. Ugh, I could put it in like a sauce. Yeah. Like a root sauce. And then put that on vegetables. Yeah, that'd be good. Or just on vegetables melted with like salt. Yeah, that'd be good too. What else could I do with this batch of butter? Put it in the freezer for later. Yeah. Thinking about it. It's getting there. What else could I do with this delicious butter? Oh yeah, you can also, as another step, you can clarify the butter where you just heat it up and then strain out all the milk solids so that it can last longer and withstand higher temperatures and recipes, and you know, it's more healthy. So straining out more of the milk solids, which is the thing that makes it spoil. Taking its sweet time with that. Let's see. What else could I put this butter in? Yeah. You'd also like melt it, put it on popcorn. Yeah, that's pretty good. You can do a lot with butter. That's why we usually make butter. Oh. Start to slow down. Real quick, see what it looks like. Right, so it's getting, stop it to show you here. So it's at cream stage. If you're gonna do whipped cream, this way you can do that. I'll show you. So it's all fluffy. We're not gonna be doing whipped cream, we're gonna be doing butter. So I'll put this back on. Keep running it until it turns. The whipped cream is still pretty good too. I actually have another thing that makes whipped cream. I have a whipped cream maker that's different from this. You can do that too. What can I do with whipped cream? Yeah, I add sugar to my whipped cream, and so I generally don't use this to make the whipped cream. I didn't add sugar beforehand. Starting to get chunkier. I don't know if you can see this, but it is. Okay, got air bubbles. Turning a little bit slower. So it's getting there. Let's see. Oh, another thing I do with my butter is I also melt it and I add it to my lotion bars that I make, which have cocoa butter and shea butter in them too. I'll put a link in the description if you want to get some of those. So that's another fun thing you can do with butter. I know some people like to have seafood and then they dip it in butter and lobster and stuff. But yeah, it's getting there. So close. It's really chunky. Probably it's gonna break this chunk and then start spraying buttermilk everywhere. So there's that. Oh, and then I found this is the fastest way to make it and then the way with the least mess. Because the other way that I was able to make it was with a hand mixer and to avoid the mess on that one. Would not recommend. I mean, it still worked, but it just went everywhere. You can also use other ways to... Well, I'm not sure. You know, I might have to try that. I've never made butter with a blender before. I don't know if a blender would be able to do it. I don't know if a blender has enough power to do it, though. No, wait. Probably not, because I use blender to make ice cream with the cream in it. I know this will turn to butter. I don't know, maybe I'm not putting it on long enough. I might make that another video if you guys care to find out. So close. I'm gonna start chipping a little bit. Yeah, it's getting really thick. So it's it'll be a lot of white, it'll suddenly turn, so they're just watching it like a hawk here. Let's see what else we can do with the butter. Yeah. We have a lot of we do a lot of sweets with butter. I'll really put it in a lot of savory things. May have to change that. But then I noticed, and this is something I noticed from owning goats, the best time to make butter would be in the fall, because that's when the goats are producing the most butter fat. Because in the spring, they have their babies are eating a lot, so they'll make a lot of milk, like 2 gallons worth, but they won't make very much butter fat, only like 2% or something. And then in the fall, they'll be producing less milk, but the butter fat will be higher. So you could like get a different amount of butter from like the same jar. Like in the fall, like a jar like this would be like to make like a pound and a half of butter, whereas right now it'll like make barely a pound or a pound maximum. And then, okay, spin it. turning a little faster now. We'll check it and see how it's doing. Well, it's getting closer. Spinning it. And yeah. Close to breaking. And then I don't really do anything with the buttermilk because goat buttermilk doesn't behave the same way as cow buttermilk. I don't really do much with that. I mean, I could try the buttermilk pancakes, but I don't know how that would taste. The sound of it changed. And it's thinking. Spinning faster now. Watching the buttermilk splashes. Get a little bit more. I think it's separated. Oh, almost there. Starting to vibrate a little more. Notice a bit more. There we go. It's churned. What buttermilk splashing around? Show you. It's separated now. Get all that butter. Let's scooch this out of the way so you guys can see better. All that buttermilk. Chunks of butter. And it's stuck on the blade sometimes. Yeah. Put that up there. And then I'm gonna stir it a little bit so that we can get as much buttermilk out as possible. And then I generally use the strainer. You can use cheesecloth or if you want the strainer, because then that way you can smash it as hard as you want. Really tell it what for. Almost there. And then I'm just gonna add some salt to it. Keep it simple. Once it's pretty dry. To change hands, wreck one hand. Not sure if you guys can see this or not. Say that the salt is thoroughly mixed. And then about a spoon. Put that in this bin. Now the jar here will probably fill this up to fill up this whole bin, which will be about a pound. But since I'm impatient and I want to taste it, I have some toast. Which, yay, it's still warm. So I wanna see how this turned out.
It's really good. This came out good. I wish you guys could taste this, but then I don't know how logistics of that would work out. Well, anyway, folks, as this is, I have to run the rest of this. I hope I'll see you guys in the next video. You can tell me down below what you want to see me do with the rest of this butter, because I could do a lot. But I'm thinking about clarifying it. Or, what's the term? Ghee, that's what they call it. So, be sure to like and subscribe and all that fun stuff. And I'll see y'all in the next video.